Why doesn't win and losses matter in the WWE? Let's get on that.
Whenever a wrestler in any wrestling promotion loses an important match, the internet wrestling community goes crazy. The hardcore wrestling fans, marks, or whatever you want to call them, are very quick to jump the gun and say that this wrestler or that wrestler is buried or ruined because of that loss. And I think that is a terrible way to look at it. It's completely wrong. In this video, I'm going to explain why I think wins and losses don't really matter too much in the WWE. Let's take a look at a perfect example. Drew McIntyre is somebody who's been recently losing some WWE title matches against Bobby Lashley. This caused many wrestling fans to complain online, claiming that he has been ruined, which is not the case at all. Drew McIntyre may have lost those matches, but he is far from being ruined. The company is most likely going to insert him into a new storyline that's going to lead to some victories. Losing a few matches does not make or break him anyways. I think it's important for wrestling fans to understand this. Since WWE is predetermined, the writers and bookers can quickly change the momentum of a superstar for the story that they want to tell. With Drew McIntyre, they can have him win some matches and eventually earn a US title match against Sheamus if they want. On the contrary, if they don't want to go down that route, they could have him lose some more matches to tell the story that he's never been the same ever since losing the WWE Championship. That way, they can take him and then move him over to SmackDown to give him a fresh start. The win or loss is essentially just a plot device to tell a story. Yeah. It is nothing more than that. Too many wrestling fans get into it thinking it's deeper than it is. There are so many examples of wrestlers who have a ton of losses that are considered to be some of the greatest wrestlers to ever set foot inside a squared circle, and I'll name you some of them. Chris Jericho has a total of 833 losses in the WWE, and Triple H is also very close to that number with having 835 losses under his belt. Randy Orton also has over 1,000 L's in his record book, and on top of this list is Kane with the most losses in WWE history with 1,215 losses. Like I really believe that if social media was a bigger deal in the late 90s and early 2000s, so many people would have made some stupid statements claiming that those legends I just named were ruined or buried at one point in their career, and that is just an incorrect and ridiculous thing to say. The same thing is practically happening now with the modern day talents. I wanted to take a look at specific wrestlers where people constantly question WWE's booking, where in reality they really should not be doing so.
I'm sorry, I was a little bit hungry when I saw this video, and I was like, we can go ahead and make a video now. Here's the thing, here's my thought on the win-loss record. Okay? AEW does it good. They do it good in their own thing, because everyone is entitled to do it right and wrong however they want, because right or wrong could boost the character or it could worsen the character. Since we're on WWE, let's talk about it. What he said is true. Daniel Bryan's, 17 second loss to Sheamus, they turned into a big turning point to him becoming a megastar, basically, in the WWE. Same with Becky Lynch. I'm not saying that you don't have a right to speak. You do have your rights to voice your opinion, because sometimes here's the thing that he's not mentioning. Because people voice their opinions, sometimes they looked at it and they said, whatever the original story was, scrap. No. It may be the good storyline that was scrapped, or a really, really bad one that they thought was good and they thought it would work. It may look, may sound horrible, but it may look good. So, no, not exactly. I wouldn't say they don't know what they're talking about. I would just say that when it comes to certain ones, it kind of one of those you can see where it's obviously going. Just calm down. But for those that are just speaking on, let's say, a random episode of Spice, a superstar, Naomi lost. It's not the worst. It's not the end of the world because Naomi lost that. Not the end of the world. What would be the end of the world is you have your biggest star. Let's say. Let's take it back. You know when Alexa Bliss first won the championship? Imagine if she didn't win. That right there would have angered some people because Alexa Bliss should have won to establish her character, establish who she is. That is what I would say. That's something. Drew McIntyre losing to Bobby Lashley for story purposes to have him basically go somewhere else to go carry on to fight for the title. That's fine. That's fine. Can't wait for it. Can't wait for him to have to go to SmackDown and just be like, Claymore, 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 Universal Champion, Claymore. I can't wait for it. Let's see what else you got to say.
Sami Zayn is probably the best example. The man has been losing a lot of matches in 2021. In fact, I think he won his first singles match at Hell in a Cell against Kevin Owens since December of 2021. Yes, this man has not won a single match since December, and that's 7 months. Okay. With that being said, it is easy to say he's ruined, but he's not. WWE have purposely put him in a position to lose to further elaborate on the storyline that there is a conspiracy against him. I think it's genius writing, and he needs to suffer the losses in order for his character to develop. On the other hand, before this year, Sheamus was one of the biggest losers over the last year. In 2020, it was not a good year for our current United States champion because he lost notable matches against the likes of Jeff Hardy and Drew McIntyre, but none of that really mattered because when it came to pushing him into the US title picture, the WWE just booked him to win some matches and then he became a champion and now he's a credible badass champ. Matt Riddle.
I'm gonna take this. One thing WWE does good with a push is that sometimes it's completely out of nowhere. And you don't know where it's leading to. Like, it shocked me when I realized they were going to push Shinsuke Nakamura. Because I was like, are we going to see Shinsuke Nakamura versus Roman Reigns? I was like, that'd be a pretty good, nice little match. But it's obvious that Roman's going to win that. It was obvious. That's what I thought we were originally going with him going to take so, that what's-his-name was going to... he was going to fight Seth, beat Seth, or in this case, lose to Seth, so Cesaro could step in against him, but go against Roman. That's why I thought the storyline was going to go at first. It didn't. Can it go at now? Possibly. It possibly can. If they give him the Universal Championship. What are you doing? Okay, I didn't know. He just came out the bathroom looking at me and going, like, where? But yeah.
I love you.
I love you too.
You're so sexy.
Thank you. God dang, them things look huge.
That's things, the point.
They look huge with your hair like that. Still adorable. But, what I'm stating is this. That was my thought process of that. That's what I thought was going. It's fine that it didn't go that way. He's now the King of the Ring, which is dope. Because now we can get the King of Strong Style, which... If they do it proper, he probably finna be Intercontinental Champion again or a contender for the Universal Title. If he's a contender for the Intercontinental Championship, I expect him to win, of course. But if he's not, and he's just about to go on a tear of late, and then continue on with this tear until whatever happens next. I don't think it should be a title win for him personally, because I don't really see him like taking an Intercontinental Championship and elevating it by doing that, unless the King of the Ring character is to elevate it, and he just continues to, you know, make the title more worth it. That could be the only thing I could see. Other than that, I don't know. I don't know. Ooh, excuse me. What could be done? What could be said for it? I don't know, to be honest. But besides that, yeah.
Is another name of somebody who was ruled as ruined from the first month of his career on the main roster. Thankfully,
he right. That is so true. I thought they ruined my boy quick. I thought they ruined my boy Matt Riddle. I was like, nah, you should have left him in NXT. Y'all gonna ruin him. Don't ruin Keith Lee. Don't ruin Matt Riddle. Don't ruin NXT in general, bro. They doing that to Shayna, in my personal opinion, with what her character's doing right now. Her character right now should be on an absolute tear. With the crowds or without the crowds, she should be, in my personal opinion, I would prefer Shayna Baszler's character at this moment to be wrecking every single female or male or anyone in her way. I expect her to destroy her. The whole Alexa Bliss thing, she should have beat Alexa. She should have beat Alexa to the point where not only was the match stopped, but the match was given to Alexa because it was a no contest type thing. Like, she seriously beat the demon out of Alexa. That's what I wanted to see. That's what I wanted to see happen. That's not what happened. I'm a little upset about it. I love me a lot of the NXT wrestlers because of this in particular thing. Their styles mesh well in NXT. When they go to the main roster, it kind of is a flip-flop sometimes. Some of them can do it perfect, like Keith Lee. He can do it perfect. My boy can do it perfect. That's my boy. But that's neither here nor there. All I'm saying is they could have. I thought they ruined my boy. Glad they didn't.
Writers found a new story for him, and he's been picking up some wins with his tag team partner, Randy Orton. Cesaro has lost matches for the last decade to finally be given a chance for the World Championship match in 2021 against Roman Reigns. It literally does not matter that he lost matches for the last 10 years. Kevin Owens is another really good example of somebody who can lose a bunch of matches and then end up in the world title picture with Roman Reigns when it's needed. At the end of the day, the wrestlers will win and lose some matches. That is going to happen, and fans should not be stressing out about the record. That just makes WWE's job impossible. People need to lose some matches, and that is perfectly fine. That is life. We lose, we fail, we get up, and we move on. So many greats have lost WWE matches and have so many losses in their record book, and they were just fine. Anyways, that is it for the video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you all enjoyed.
I always enjoy your videos, bro. I always enjoy your videos. I do disagree with some points that you make, but I enjoy your videos at the end of it all. Let's carry on with the rest of our day.